Petroni,
David Wegner,
Dmitry Aldakov,
Peter Weiss.
And in this video, we are going to present our article about
prospects
of chalcopyrite type
nanocrystals
for energy applications.
We are working in the Institute of Nanosciences and Cryogenics at the CEA and at the University in Grenoble, France. The use of semiconductor nanocrystals or quantum dots for energy conversion, in particular solar energy conversion, has exploded in the last few years due to their intense light absorption, bright luminescence, and high stability.
Moreover, their absorption and emission properties can be tuned by simple variation of the size to cover different regions of the spectrum.
However, the most used materials up to now are based on highly toxic metal, like cadmium. A very interesting alternative emerged in the last few years, the class of ternary chalcopyrites, named after this mineral. You can see here the dark tiny crystals. It's copper iron sulfide.
This class of compounds is composed by a monovalent and a trivalent metal and two chalcogenides. This leads to a variety of possible structures.
To understand the unique properties of chalcopyrite type nanocrystals, we need to take a closer look at their physical properties.
After the excitation of the electron from the valence band to the conduction band, the created exciton can recombine under emission of photoluminescence. Thereby, the photoluminescence properties of chalcopyrites differ from popular binary systems like cadmium selenide quantum dots. We can see that photoluminescence line width is with more than 100 nanometer much broader, and the effective Stokes shift can be up to 500 millielectron volts. These spectral properties evidence that the direct exciton emission is not the major radiative pathway and that in chalcopyrites several intra-bandgap states are involved. Although the main contribution on the optical transition is still under debate, recent studies converge to a free-to-bound mechanism, in which the electron is delocalized in the conduction band and the holes being localized at copper ions. Additionally, sulfur vacancies and indium on copper sites are origin of defects. In our paper, we summarized electrochemical and optical properties of ternary nanocrystals with different sizes and compositions and found some trends within the data. First of all, copper deficiency resulted in an increased optical and electrochemical bandgap. As expected from the quantum confinement effect, the decrease in size led to an increased optical and electrochemical bandgap.
Now that we have heard about these very interesting properties of these chalcopyrite quantum dots, it will be very interesting to check their photovoltaic properties. The potential of these materials for photovoltaics is explained by their band gap values, which are situated in ideal range for single junction solar cells. Another advantage is their high absorption coefficients and also the absence of toxic metals, of course. Among different types of solar cells using quantum dots, we believe that the most promising and adapted for these materials is the quantum dot sensitized solar cell.
One of the reasons is because the amount of active material is much lower, which is a critical advantage when elements of lower abundancy such as indium are considered. And because here we use just one monolayer or submonolayer of these quantum dots. Another reason is that the charge transport in nanocrystalline phase is no longer required because the charge dissociation takes place at the interface with the wide bandgap nanostructured oxide semiconductors. Considering different promising architectures for solar cells, we believe that luminescent solar concentrators are of great importance. In this case, quantum dots are embedded into a transparent waveguide matrix to absorb direct or diffuse sunlight. And then they re-emit photons of lower energy, which are then converted by conventional silicon solar cells. This type of devices can be used for building integrated photovoltaics. And the advantage of chalcopyrite quantum dots here is that they have high absorption coefficients, high luminescence quantum yields, and also they have a large Stokes shift, which will allow to limit the reabsorption problem.
Separated charges can also be used to perform chemical reactions in order to store solar energy in the form of chemical energy, for example through water splitting. Chalcopyrite nanocrystals proved their efficiency in this field too, especially if used in combination with co-catalysts like metal nanoparticles or molecular catalysts.
In order to fully benefit of the high potential of chalcopyrite type nanocrystals, still significant progress has to be made in the understanding of their fundamental properties and in their chemical synthesis.
So we have plenty of work to do.